Hello, hello.
Hello.
So it would be good to also see some MATLAB. And in our sitecom.alto.fi, we have a long page dedicated to MATLAB with different examples here. Maybe the interactive usage of MATLAB is not what we're after right now. And most likely you're familiar with it, but it's nice to see how we can run, for example, serial scripts or array jobs with MATLAB. In practice, I mean the situation is quite similar to what we are doing with what we did with the Python case. So we wanna run a script. For example, I'm gonna call it MATLAB dot, and let's call it serial.sh. All right, so now I copy what we have in our documentation just for simplicity. Basically, of course, you already see that what we need to do is make sure that we have MATLAB there. Right now, I'm just requesting for 5 minutes and nothing, small amount of memory and getting the output store somewhere. So then what we normally wanna use, the way we normally wanna use MATLAB in a batch job in a serial script is that we don't actually need the graphical part. So often we don't need this Java virtual machine that is kind of needed to run all the IDE, integrated development environment of MATLAB, and also this no splash. It's basically kind of similar thing that relates to the fact that we don't need the graphical interface. And then with minus R, it's like we are telling MATLAB to please run some command. So basically here it would go the actual how can I say, the actual command that we need to run. So I'm inventing now some let's call it my function, and maybe we can even pass some parameter to this my function. So I'm setting some parameters that we need to define previously. So let's say that n equals to 3 and m equals to 2, something like this. But then something that is important, although kind of they fixed it, or some this has changed recently with MATLAB. But in general, even though it might have changed, I think it's good practice to know that MATLAB has quit. So after running the command, MATLAB itself would not kind of shut down. So it's important to also add this exit zero. Idea being that, you don't want to keep there. Okay, in this case, if we are requesting only 5 minutes for this job, but you don't want to, wait basically that the time expires when you can already release the resources. Okay, so then you can already see the strategy here that these numbers that are changing, they could be, for example, this array ID that you can then pass to your function, which can be a wrapper of something bigger that can take the array ID and then, parallelized across multiple parameters, input parameters. So of course you also need something like call myfun.m, something silly in this case. So function myfun, and it was m and n, and maybe I don't know, just a disp of something that
I
you would
think
do normally.
the parameters might have been other way around, but I'm not certain.
Oh yeah, the letters, yeah. I was following, I thought it was alphabetical order, but
Is it important to have the same name for the function and the file as in the command?
well, it's like if you do it like that, then you make it easier for MATLAB when you're looking for the help. So that I could also write the help of this function here. My fun does this and that. Then MATLAB, it's easier life for MATLAB, but otherwise this here could be, or like it doesn't need to match, but it you can use more of these interactive features if the name of the function and the name of the file are the same. So maybe first I test this interactively on the login node, or actually even better, as we said many times, let's not use the login node. I'm just getting some random node interactively. And okay, I got CS147, so I try module.matlab to make sure, yeah, if my dyslexia wouldn't be. yes, so now, of course, I'm not able to run any graphical, so this is the MATLAB from 1996, basically, and then here in this folder, well, these were all the stuff that we ran for the course, but there is this myfun, which we can call with some numbers, and it just displays the numbers that I passing. And it even, so, okay, seems that everything is working. And I can get out of this specific node. So we're back to the login node. And now we can have a last look at the job that we will submit. So it will load MATLAB. And with these two parameters, it's gonna call myfun. I guess this will be very fast, or kind of not too fast, because MATLAB always takes some time to start up. So I guess that would be most of the time that is needed, but yes, this is done. If we look at the history, so yeah, the last thing that was called was MATLAB, and the output file, I could reshape my screen a little bit. So it was serial matlab.out. Which just, so it's interesting actually that you even see in the output file kind of what you saw interactively, that MATLAB gets started and you get also this output of the function. So in our example page, I don't know if I also should I share the example page, or I just wanted to show more about the kind of more complex scenarios.
Sure.
So I need to, well, I can't actually, because I'm now sharing only this window, so I would need to stop my stream, my sharing. So yeah, so I don't know how we can do it now without maybe stopping the stream.
Yeah, maybe you can describe what's in there, what kind of things are there in the MATLAB page.
Well, basically there are other ways of using the, like this, in this case, like this was a kind of one core MATLAB that is running something simple, and okay, you can scale it with the array jobs or with the, but in MATLAB also uses some sort of internal parallelization, because some functions are made so that if there is more than one CPU available in the node where they're running, they can run this multi-threading. So in our documentation, we also have examples on running this MATLAB multi-thread. Idea being that some of the code inside, let's say that you want to invert a matrix, can actually utilize more than one CPU per task. So since I'm now in this window, I can show how it would look like. So with something like this, you would, let me copy it well. You would request, for example, 4 CPUs per task and 2 GB of memories, and this specifically then calls a MATLAB function, which is basically the inversion of a matrix that utilizes the parallelization, meaning that in the node that you end up, the MATLAB sees that you have four CPUs, and then those can be used in parallel to invert the matrix. MATLAB also uses other system for the parallelization, like the so-called par pool or parallel toolbox. And it's somewhat similar to the kind of to the array jobs. It's just that now it happens within one node, so that in the node that you are, for example, you have the say four CPUs per task, then those the task that you're doing within the par four loop can take advantages of the multiple CPUs. Did you want to say something, Simo, or?
No, I think it's quite clear that there's more stuff in the page, and it's possible to find all kinds of information there.
Yeah. Okay, I guess, I don't know if you were planning other examples.
Thanks a lot.